Hey everyone, this is Lynn from Transcona CrossFit, and we're doing a live stream today because I've got some of my, well, beginner rookies. They're a month into their fitness journey so far. They've done the on-ramp, they've done the regular classes, they have now joined the CrossFit Opens. And so what I want to do is I want to talk about tomorrow's on-ramp, starting at 6:15, and getting these girls a journey in, well, in today's episode of the, I guess kind of like mindset behind an athlete kind of thing. So this is Candace, and this is Ashley. Ashley started with me first, so I'm going to talk to Ashley first. And there was a few things that was said right when we kind of met, and so I kind of hope that you're okay with talking about that. And then maybe we can help inspire everybody. And then this is Candace. She was dragged along to a workshop that I was speaking at back at the beginning of January, and pretty much signed up for the gym the next day and has been with me ever since. So we'll talk about their journeys, their struggles in getting here every day, and just kind of how their journey has been so far at TCF. So Ashley, you contacted me back in December, I believe, right? You started in December, at the end of it, before the new year. So why don't you explain a little bit of how it was for you just walking in the door, because we just had a meeting first.
Yes, when I walked in the door, Lynn greeted me, and I knew right then was going to sign up. It didn't matter what she said. It was her personality, like right from the minute I walked in the door.
She really likes my dancing. tells me all the time that I'm a distraction in class. Okay, so that's really cool. Like, but what about that? Like, it kind of always takes me back a little bit that's what snagged you in was my personality. Like, what was it about like the gym? Was it the atmosphere? Was it just like it just was a kindred spirit meeting?
Yeah, it just. Just came across it. And
I think the line that you used the most was, if you would have went into any other CrossFit gym, you wouldn't have signed up. So that was really, really cool moment for me, and it was pretty, was like very, again, humbling moment for that. So you're a month and a bit in now. How has it been getting here? You've got an unlimited pass. You started off with a regular. Right away, she went to unlimited because 3 days wasn't enough for her. So how has that been so far for you from day one to now? How are you finding the progress, the struggles, the praising moments?
Well, we'll just say I wouldn't be here if it wasn't for Lynn, because I've had a lot of ups and downs, and she just keeps bringing me back.
That's very cool. And in the ups and downs, so when you're here, we've had some moments. We've had some give me a hug moments, and we've had some high five moments, because you've done such a great job. Like, if you guys ever just come here just to try a class, these girls here, both of them, just in the heart and how hard they work and just in the showing up and the daily, like, stuff that they have to come here every day to do, you guys own a daycare, right? At-home daycare. So they have to deal, like, they come here at 5:30 in the morning, then they deal with kids all day, and then they deal with their personal lives in the evening. So they're doing their work in the first thing in the morning when they have time to do it, so that they're set up for the rest of the day. So right now, we're a month and a half in. What do you find is like the goal? What was the goal for you just to start?
To lose weight.
Just to lose weight. Has that goal changed since then?
Yeah, just to get healthy, not even just physically, but mentally as well.
Yeah, because that's huge, right? You guys always start with like a base of a why, and then the why always changes. And now you sign up for the CrossFit Opens. Yes, that was a look. But how excited are you that a month and a half ago, this isn't even a thing that was a thought? Like, to compete in the CrossFit Opens? Like, really?
Didn't even know of it.
No. So now what are you, now we had a seminar last week about us setting a goal for the CrossFit Opens. The CrossFit Opens start February 23rd. So we're, 2 weeks away from that. What's the goal for you from now into the 2 weeks and then 5 weeks after that for the Opens?
Just to prepare myself between now and then for what is to come in the Open.
And what's a goal for you from now until pretty much the end of like the month? Okay, so your goal has changed to just getting all around healthy with the mindset and with the gym. Is there any other major goals or anything major that you're kind of like, yeah, that's what I want?
To finish my schooling for my ECE3.
Okay, yeah. That's awesome. That's huge. And that happened because of the workshop, right? Yeah. So that workshop was huge. That was the Invest in Yourself workshop that we had done. And that's just awesome. Yep. Like, huge realizations. Okay, leading from the workshop to this one. She was dragged in by her to come to the workshop. She's like, I have a friend, I'm paying for her, too bad she has to come now. That's pretty much how she got you to come. So you came in and you had no idea what to expect. What changed your mind to sign up for here?
Listening to you talk, it was, you didn't come on and say, you need to eat this, this, and this, and you need to train this, and this, and this. You said, we'll find what fits for you. And then you told me to come to practice the next day, and I said, okay. And I did. I you can ask Ashley, I went over and over again, maybe I should do this, maybe I shouldn't do this, maybe I shouldn't do this. Then I found myself getting my workout clothes, and I got my shoes, and I got my bottle ready, and I was like, I'm going to bed, and it's before midnight. So, yeah.
Huge change. Okay, and so you came for day one. You had no idea what to expect. What was, like, a major realization the first class you came to?
You got me to do some weights to see where it was at, and I was stronger than I thought I was.
Yeah, because you back squatted what? Like, it was something ridiculous. Like, it was 160 pounds or something. Right off the hop, 160 pounds, and I was like, because my little legs don't handle that much weight anymore. But so that was huge, right? I think the surprise of your deadlift was 265 pounds. She had to beat mine by 10. I challenged her to beat mine, so she did that. And just like the accomplishments that you had within the first 2 weeks was freaking huge, like ridiculous huge. So from you, you're about a month in now. What has changed from day one to now for you?
When I started, it was just about losing weight. That was all I cared about. I wanted to lose the weight. Well, the end goal was to get pregnant, and I need to lose the weight to get pregnant. So, I mean, that's just a major overall goal, but watching my husband and my daughter now being so supportive, and my daughter saying the other day, I love how healthy you're getting, changed it.
Changed it. Yeah. So how has it changed? What's the why now?
I want to be able to do her ballet things on the floor. I'm not quite there yet, but
yeah,
just be able to keep up with her.
Yeah. Well, and her story's pretty cool because she brought her daughter yesterday, and her daughter, at the grand opening, her daughter did the workouts at the grand opening. It was really cute to see. And then yesterday we were doing yoga, and she was sitting there. She went and got herself a mat, rolled it out, and she was doing some warrior two with you, and she was doing some stuff. So it was pretty cool to see. So now you have also signed up for the opens with a little bit of twisting of the arm by someone. What's the goal now for you from 2 weeks and then 5 weeks after that? What's a goal for you?
To do at least one of everything.
One of everything?
One of everything.
Okay.
They say you can at least do one.
Yep.
So yeah, that's my goal for then. And by the end, it's to be able to say that I actually finished all 5 workouts.
How awesome is that? That's a cool goal. All right. So if you guys are cool with it, I'm going to ask you guys one more question and then one question after that. What's the hardest part daily for you guys in this part of the journey? What's the hardest thing that you guys struggle with daily?
Getting out of bed at 4:30 in the morning.
Getting out of bed at 4:30 in the morning? What about you?
Mine inside the gym is when I feel like I can't do something.
When you can't do something, yeah, you get pretty frustrated pretty quickly. Okay, and what about that is the frustrating part, when you can't do something?
Because I think it's my mind that's stopping me from at least trying it or continuing. Like, I'll second guess myself that I'm not doing it properly, so that I'm like, I can't do that, I can't do that. And then, like, then I get mad at myself for thinking that I can't do it.
Yeah. So it's like a mindset battle, yeah. Back and forth. Okay, and now with that, what's the biggest accomplishment in the month and the month and a half that you guys have been here? What's the biggest thing that you guys are like, holy fuck, I'm high-fiving myself every day for this?
Getting here and doing the workouts.
Getting here and doing the workouts.
No matter like how hard it is to actually be able to do something.
Yeah.
And, like, whether it's the actual workout or if it's modified for myself.
Very cool. How about yourself? Biggest high five moment for you?
Yesterday's workout.
Yesterday's workout. It was called Clusterfuck, and it was called that for a reason, because it's a very, very hard workout. It's not easy. I wasn't going to let you quit on that one, and I told Karen that you weren't allowed to get any modifications. So yesterday's workout was 7 rounds. It was 7 clusters, which is a squat clean and a thruster. It was 7
back squats.
back squats with the bar. It was 5 push press and 5 burpee snatch combo. And it was 7 rounds. It took you, what, about 40 minutes to do that? And she finished it. So that's a huge accomplishing moment. Okay, now you guys have the CrossFit Opens you guys have signed up for. You guys have shown up pretty much every day for the last month, month and a half. You guys have tried everything from gymnastics on the rings. Oh, and that was a huge moment for both of these girls. FYI, they're like, we can't hold ourselves up on the pull-up rig. They got up on a box and they managed to get 10, 15 seconds each. Okay, huge. When you think that you can't do something and you have a team that's here to show you that you guys can, and then changing the I can't to I can's, okay? Daily battles of the I can's to the I can's. And then it's loving yourself, saying I love you anyways when it doesn't happen, and you've always got tomorrow to do it. You can't do it today, but there's always tomorrow, right? You guys have done such a phenomenal job. If you guys can describe TCF in like 5 words or less to get people to sign up for OnRamp tomorrow, what would you guys say? Let's start with you.
Don't think about it, do it.
Don't think about it, do it. You want to be my marketing manager?
Second family.
Second family. Yeah, and that's absolutely what it is. TCF is all about community. It's all about family. You definitely have the people here to help you in a burpee situation where you have to struggle for burpees. You got people helping you out with the burpees. You got people giving you high fives. And I believe here with the Coaches Development Program, we have a client who's not taking the Coaches Development. And she's not what we would call a regular coach. She's been with me for 7 years. And she's got her own determination, her own goals, and she's going through the program, and she's inspired you. We have pictures of her. She's got, this girl is what TCF is all about. Karen is what TCF is all about. And so I love having coaches like her here because that is helping motivate you, helps motivate you, and it helps grow our family. So if you guys have any questions of OnRamp, give me a call. It's 204-688-9178. You guys can register online at www.transformingcrossfit.com. Head over to the Register Now tab and get yourselves ready because OnRamp starts tomorrow at 6:15 p.m. We do it for 2 weeks. We run it 3 days a week, Monday, Tuesday, and Thursday. And if you guys want to join a family, if you guys want to just, what did you say? Don't think about it, do it now kind of thing. Just sign up. If you guys have been on the fence, just do it now. All right, guys, that's it. Enjoy your Sunday. Have a good one. Bye.